Hello everyone, my name is Hannah and welcome to today's video. So last week I made a video about the top 10 books that I want to read this fall, and it was basically just my TBR for the season, but since I've already made a video about all of the books I want to read this fall, today I wanted to make a list of recommendations of books that I think you should read this fall. But I wanted to mention some books that I don't mention all the time on my channel. I've definitely mentioned a decent number of these books on my channel plenty of times before, but some of them I feel like I haven't talked about very recently, and some of them I've never really mentioned at all on my channel. So yeah, I thought it was a good new list of books that I don't think I've put together before. It's been quite a few years since I've made a fall reading recommendations, so I thought it was just about time to finally make another one, and I hope that you're able to find a good new fall read out of this list. Before we get into my list of recommendations, I do want to thank today's sponsor, which is Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning platform that has thousands of classes on so many different subjects. If you've been interested in learning or developing any new skill, Skillshare is the place to go to learn any of that. With so many of us staying home right now, learning a new skill or developing a skill is a great way to fill your time. If you're anything like me and you don't really know how to structure your time outside of school, Skillshare is a great way to help you develop that because you can take classes at your own pace, but you can also help build your own structure and your own schedule with it. Recently, I've wanted to get back into just like personal writing, writing essays and creative writing because it's something that I really miss doing and something that I wish I had developed more. So I've been taking this creative personal writing course by Ashley C. Ford, who's a writer and editor, and it's been really great for the creative part of my brain because I haven't written anything for a while, and taking this course has been really motivational for me in getting back into writing. So whether you're looking for a new way to explore your creativity, or if you're trying to just learn some new skills or fill your time, Skillshare is a great place to help you do that. The first 1,000 people to use the link in my description box will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership, and after that it's only around $10 a month. So if it's something you're interested in, be sure to check out that link. But once again, thank you so much to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Alright, so without any further ado, let's get into my list of my favorite fall reads. So this first book is a book that I would classify as like a perfect fall book. Something about this book just feels like the season. It feels like the perfect time to read it. It might be in part because I first read this book in fall, but I feel like for anyone who's read this book, you probably know what I mean. This book just feels like autumn, like truly in its essence. And that is The Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. This is a historical fiction novel set during the time of the Spanish Civil War. It's set in about 1945, and it's set actually in two different timelines technically, because 1945 is where our main character is, and he's having this story told to him that takes place like, I don't even know, 30, 40 years before that. It's been some time since I've read it, so don't quote me on that, but there's the main story that's set in 1945, and then the story that's being told in the story that is set much before then. This is also a book that I have said many times I feel like is a book for people who love books, because it's about books. It's basically about this young boy who finds this book at this mysterious library called The Shadow of the Wind, and then he finds out that all of the books written by this author were actually burned, and there are none of them really left in existence, so he wants to know more about the mystery behind this author and what happened to him and what happened to his books, and it's so good. It's very sad at times, pretty disturbing at other times, especially because it's set during the time of like a civil war, so obviously the theme of war is pretty prevalent in this, but it is truly one of my favorite books ever. It is actually part of a series, it's the first book in a series. I still haven't read the other books, but it can absolutely stand on its own, hence why I haven't actually read the other books yet. I highly, highly recommend you check it out if you haven't already. I know it's pretty popular, it's considered like a modern classic at this point, but I feel like there's still plenty of people who haven't read it, so I'm gonna keep talking about it until like everyone reads it. It's also a book I've mentioned many times on my channel, but I feel like it's been a while since I've really, really talked about it, so that's why I wanted to include it in this video as well. That and because I also think it's just a perfect fall book. There is no better season to read this book. I mean, read it during any season. If you don't get to it this fall, that's fine. Read it whenever. But like, if you want something that's gonna make you feel like fall, I highly recommend this one. Next up on my list, we have one of my all-time favorite series, which when the last book for this finally comes out, this might end up becoming like my favorite series. I don't know. Don't quote me. Depends on how it ends. Depends on how much heartbreak I have to suffer. I don't know if that'll make me like it more or less, honestly. But that is none other than the Ember and the Ashes series. Listen, if you haven't started reading these yet, fix that, because you need to. I've said this before and I will say it again, An Ember in the Ashes is one of, if not the best YA series currently out there. This series deserves the amount of hype that Siri, not you, I'm trying to say series. This series deserves the hype and attention that Siri, I swear to God. These books deserve the attention that series like Throne of Glass and The Cruel Prince get, and it doesn't get that attention. But it deserves it because I think, first of all, it's better, but even if it weren't better, it's just as good, it's just as intense, it's just as dramatic and angsty and everything that you want in a YA fantasy series, and it's exceptional. It goes above and beyond, and you need to read it, okay? I've read these books twice through at this point. I've read the first one like 3 times, and then I've read the second and the third one, which are the only other ones that are out. The fourth one is coming out in December, I believe, so not too far away. But yeah, I've reread them because I like them that much, and like that says a lot because I have not reread that many of my favorite series in recent years. Recently, I haven't been like very much into rereading things, even though I used to reread books all the time. Like, I would just reread my favorite books, and nowadays I will occasionally reread like a standalone or something that I really love because it's not as much commitment. But I've actually reread this whole series, so if that doesn't tell you how much I like it, I don't know what will. The romance, the angst, the political drama, the commentary, everything about this book is great and you need to read it. That's all I'm gonna say. I have talked about how much I love this book countless times, but I always feel like it's not enough because I always feel like there aren't enough people who hype up this book, and more people should hype up this book because it's that good. It's so good. Please read it, okay? Just please read it. My heart's been torn into pieces since I first read this book and I haven't recovered since. So yeah, if you want a really good fall fantasy series to read, because I feel like this is perfect for fall since it's like very dark and intense and I just feel like thematically it works with the season, I would definitely recommend checking out this series because it's so good and I will hype it up for the rest of time. All right, next up on my list, we have another book that I have definitely mentioned on my channel plenty of times, but I feel like it's been such a long time since I recommended this book, and that is none other than The Astonishing Color of After by Emily X. Arpan. This is a YA contemporary novel, but it has this fantasy and magical component just woven into it. It's at its core mostly a story about family, love, loss, and grief, and I really don't know how to describe it other than it's just beautiful. Like, it's breathtakingly beautiful. And I don't want to say too much because I don't want to spoil anything, but just like based on the synopsis and just the general info you should know before you go in, is that it's about this young girl whose mother recently died by suicide, and she ends up going to Taiwan to visit her maternal grandparents and her family there to try and like reconnect with her mother. And it's just so beautiful. Like, I get chills every time I think about this book because when I read this, like, one, I was not in the greatest of places myself, but something about this just touched me in a way that I did not expect, and it hasn't left me since. I read this about 2 or 3 years ago at this point. I read it around the time that it first came out, and I truly haven't stopped thinking about it since then. Like I mentioned, it's about love and grief, about identity, and about loss and guilt and how we cope with all of that and how we sometimes don't. And it's just such a beautiful YA contemporary. I feel like I will read anything that Emily X. Arpan writes because the way that this was written is just like unlike any other YA book I've ever read, and I need more. And I feel like it's just perfect for fall because it's very contemplative. Like, it's just a book that really makes you think. It's a book that makes you look inward a lot, I think. And I don't know about you, but I feel like during fall I become like very reflective and I just kind of sit there and think a lot. So I feel like this is kind of the perfect book for that. It just goes along with the theme of fall very well, and honestly, like, it's been a while since I've read some of these, so I don't know if they were all like set in fall or something, but something about all of these books just makes me think of the season fall. A lot of them I read during the fall myself, so that definitely influences my opinion, but again, I just think it's a perfect read, honestly, during any season, but especially now if you haven't picked it up yet. All right, so next up on my list, I have a book that I don't think I've ever mentioned on my channel yet. I'm not 100% positive, but I don't think I've mentioned it yet because I read it during a time where I wasn't really updating very frequently, so I don't think I've mentioned this. But that book is none other than Red, White, and Royal Blue. I read this book last December, I think. Yes, December. On a road trip with one of my best friends as we were driving from Colorado to California, and we listened to the whole thing on audiobook. And let me tell you, it was one of the best reading experiences I've ever had. First of all, it was my first time ever like listening to an audiobook with another person, like entirely all the way through. I've done buddy reads and stuff with people before where we read the book at the same time together, but I'd never listened to a book with another person before, like at the same time, so that we were reacting to the same things at the same time, and it was such a fun experience. If you can do that, I highly recommend trying it out. But this was a book that I expected to enjoy because I'd heard nothing but really good things about it ever since it had come out. Even before it came out, the concept alone sounded fascinating to me, and it really made me want to read it. But I'm not a big reader of romance, like romance as a genre itself, so I didn't think that I would necessarily love it as much as some people do. But I was so wrong, because this book was so good, and it exceeded all of my expectations. I truly thought that I would just think that this was okay and that it was fun and I would understand why people like it, but it just wouldn't really be for me. But no, I love it with my whole heart. If you happen to not know what this book is about, it's about the son of the President of the United States and the Prince of England falling in love with each other. And it's about their relationship and how it complicates both of their lives. It's about identity, about coming out, about family, about politics, and it's so good. I felt like the way that this was marketed was just like, oh, it's a romance. And I was like, fun, because the concept is so out there and it sounds so fascinating. It just straight up sounds like an AU fanfic or something like that, and I'm here for it. But it ended up being one of the most heart-wrenching, heartwarming books I have ever read. It made me cry multiple times. It made me laugh out loud multiple times, and I was rooting for them the entire time because it was just so good. I know I was kind of late to the game when it came to this book because everyone had basically already read it from like the time that it first came out, and I did read it the same year it came out, I guess, but I just read it a bit late, so I felt like I missed out on the majority of like the main initial hype that had come out around the book. So by the time I read it, I felt like everyone had read it, so nobody would care if I talked about it, and I still feel that way because I feel like everyone's read it at this point, so what's the point of recommending it? But just in case you've been hesitant about reading this book, and because I wanted to talk about it because I still haven't gotten to talk about it on my channel, read Red, White, and Royal Blue. Do it. Do yourself a favor. It's such a good book. It's truly phenomenal. If you want to laugh, or you want to cry, or you just want to feel something for once, this is the book for you. I feel like this is also just like a perfect fall read since a lot of the story revolves around a presidential election, and I feel like that's pretty relevant and apt to our current situation and time, especially for those of us living in the US. But I just really like reading anything that has like romance and obviously fantasy during fall, so that's one of the reasons I picked this for this list as well, because I felt like if you want a good romance this fall, Red, White, and Royal Blue is where it's at. Like, I can't recommend it more. All right, so next up on my list, we have a book that is, I think, pretty different from most of the things I've recommended on this list so far, and that is In the Dream House by Carmen Maria Machado. I mentioned this book in a reading vlog I did a little while ago where I was trying to get myself to read something because I hadn't read a book in like 4 months, and I decided to read this and pick this up because a ton of people had been recommending it to me. And oh my god, I am so glad I did. I finished it since then, despite the fact that there's still a bookmark in here. But I have finished it, and it's truly so beautiful. Hands down, one of the best books I have read this whole year. To be fair, I have not read that many books, but still, one of the best books I have ever read. It is, like I mentioned, a memoir, and I did not expect to ever like a memoir this much. I don't read very many memoirs, but typically they're not like my favorite thing to read, but I'm so glad that I picked this up because this doesn't read like nonfiction. It reads like fantasy almost, honestly. If you've never read a book by Carmen Maria Machado, first of all, fix that, because you need to read Her Body and Other Parties, because that's also one of the greatest books I've ever read, and it's just so good. So read Her Body and Other Parties and read In the Dream House. This memoir is primarily about a relationship that she was in and how that relationship affected her, what it did to her, how it started and how it ended, and it's just heartbreaking. I would definitely give heavy content warnings for like abusive relationships, like psychologically abusive relationships. Just be conscious of that before you decide to read this if that's not something that you're comfortable reading right now. But if you're okay to read that at the moment, read this. Read it. Like, I'm not kidding. Read it. It's one of the best things I've ever read. Similarly to Red, White, and Royal Blue, I didn't think I would like this that much because, like I said, I don't really read memoirs, despite the fact that I knew that I love her writing. For some reason, I didn't think I would connect with it in the way that I ended up connecting with it. And now it's truly one of the books that I think about almost every day because it's that memorable and that impactful. It's also another book that will make you laugh at times because she's funny as hell, and it will definitely make you cry because it's depressing as hell. But yeah, if you're looking to read some nonfiction that doesn't feel like nonfiction, if you're looking to just read phenomenal writing, because I don't think I've ever found anyone who can write as well as she can, her writing is next level. I highly, highly recommend you try reading anything by Carmen Maria Machado, but especially In the Dream House. Again, not a book you necessarily have to read in fall. I just want everyone to read this as soon as possible because it's the best thing ever, so I'm recommending it now. Next on my list, we have another fantasy series that I feel like I have mentioned at least once or twice more recently, but that is the Children of Blood and Bone series by Tomi Adeyemi. I mentioned the second book of this in my last video, the top 10 books I want to read this fall, but I do want to recommend the series as a whole, or at least the first one since I've only read the first one, in this video as well, because again, I feel like people should read this. Another great YA fantasy series that I feel like is perfect for fall, definitely super hyped. Like, a lot of people read this, especially when it first came out, and it was very, very popular. But I feel like, at least from what I've seen, the hype of it has like kind of started to die out a little bit after the second book came out. I didn't hear too much about it, but that also might just be me not being online as much. But regardless of if the hype has died out or not, you should still read it, because hype doesn't matter. I get this like warmth from this book for some reason whenever I read it. Something about it just feels oddly comforting, even though it's like intense and angsty and there's a lot of drama and there's fighting and stuff going on. Like, it's just fantasy, like heavy fantasy, YA fantasy. But something about it just feels super, super comforting to me. Like, when I'm reading this book, I am in this book and the world around me just doesn't exist. And to me, that really kind of like creates the perfect fall read. Whenever I want like a really good fall book, I want something that's completely immersive. And I feel like that's a common theme that I have found in all of these books. All of these books, for one reason or another, feel very immersive to me, and Children of Blood and Bone is no exception. The mystery that's woven throughout it as well is like fascinating enough that you want to know what's going to happen, so it keeps you invested until the very end. So yeah, again, highly, highly recommend it. I know I've mentioned this one at least a few times recently, but I did want to recommend it in here as well because I think you should read it. I think if you're looking for a good fantasy series to read this fall, this is definitely one of them. All right, so next on my list, we have another book that I have mentioned before for sure, but I feel like it's been a while since I've talked about it, and I feel like the season to read this book has come, and it is now your time. If you haven't read it yet, now is the time. And that is Circe by Madeline Miller. This book is so reflective and so pretty, probably one of the prettiest books I own, and also one of the best books I own. If you haven't read Circe yet, what are you doing? I feel like based on the cover alone, I could pick this book for like a perfect fall book, because it looks like October. But despite the cover, it still feels like a perfect fall book. If you don't know anything about Circe, it is a book that is based off of the Greek mythology around the character of Circe. And Circe, if you don't know anything about her in Greek mythology, is the one who turned Odysseus's men into swine. So it's about her, but it's actually more about her backstory and how she became the Circe that most of us know from Greek mythology. And it's very, again, a very like introspective book, I think, because you're basically just in the mind of Circe this entire time. So you're really just reading from her perspective entirely. And it's just really, really beautiful. I love Greek mythology and I've been interested in it ever since I was in middle school, honestly. And getting to read about like a character that you know from those myths, but getting to find out her backstory, getting to find out why she is the way that she is just like even more fascinating to me. And that's what I always want whenever I read Greek myths or I read any myths, honestly. I just want to know more backstory about these characters that seem kind of minor sometimes. I want to know why they made the decisions they make. So the reason I like this so much is because it is just that backstory for this character that I always wanted to know more about. So yeah, it's just phenomenal. The writing in here is beautiful and it's such a good book. Again, I think it's perfect for fall because myths and storytelling, anything that's like that, I think is a perfect like fall theme, or at least it's what I like to read during the fall time. And it's just like aesthetically the most fall book I think I have on my bookshelf. And finally, last but not least, we have one more book on my list of my favorite fall reads, and that is one that I don't think I've mentioned on my channel yet. I read it a while ago. I read it last fall, I think, but I still haven't really talked about it. But that is none other than Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. So if you want to read something that's mysterious and scary and disturbing and dark and sad and basically dark academia fantasy, this is your book. I would classify this as like the perfect October book because it really and truly is. It's about this girl named Alex who attends Yale, and she is part of this secret society at Yale where they do magic. That's all I really want to say. I don't want to like spoil more, but it's about these secret societies at Yale essentially, and they are all somehow magic inclined, magic based. And the thing I really like about this book is that all of the secret societies are based off of the real secret societies that exist at Yale, and all the names of the secret societies are real. At least I'm like 99% sure. It says something about that in the back of the book. But the names like sound kind of funny, like they don't seem real, like Book and Snake and Skull and Bone, but they're like the actual names of the secret societies, which is so funny to me. But obviously there is a whole component to this that is completely fictional since it is a fantasy book. There is a major mystery that's wrapped up in into this entire book, which is basically what's driving the plot. And I really don't want to say too much about it because I don't think you should know that much. I will definitely give a heavy content warning for sexual assault and violence. That is also a theme in here as well. So just be aware of that before you go into this if you're not comfortable reading that at the moment. I do highly, highly recommend this book if you're looking for a good fantasy read. A lot of people, I feel like, have mentioned that they didn't like this because of like the pacing of it, or they felt that like the magic and the fantasy aspects of the story were just like not connected. I personally did not feel this way. I don't agree with those reviews. I felt very entrenched in the entire story all the way through. Yes, I did find the beginning to be a bit slower, but that didn't deter me from reading the rest of the book, and I felt like I understood why the pacing was the way that it was once I got to the end, if that makes sense. So I would definitely recommend you give this book a try because I think it's phenomenal. And if you want something dark and intense and what I would classify as scary, even though it's not horror by any means, I still think that you could consider it scary. I would definitely recommend picking this one up and trying it out. All right, so there you all have it. That is it for my list of my favorite books to read in fall. I hope you were able to find a new good book to read this fall out of this list, and hopefully you can find a new favorite as well. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite books are to read during the fall. I would love to know what your lists are, and let me know if you've read any of these books as well and any of your thoughts on them. But again, thank you all so much for watching this video. If you'd like to follow me on any of my social media, all my links are in the description box as always. But thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!